game number one of the grand finals of the mid brackets. We have in the Cyan, we got Griff playing as the English. Playing with 5 on wood. Yeah, 5 on wood, it's not. And the villager going to the corner, so they're gonna get someone going on water. On the red in the south, it's Katie Fear with the English as well. With 3 on wood. Getting the fourth one to build a house. I suspect that the fifth one coming out of the TC is also going on wood. And we have instead 3 villagers going into the center. This is gonna change things a lot. Ooh.
I think I know where this is going and I like it. So
you're thinking the same thing I am, right? It's they're gonna get to the short bows in action.
Yes, exactly.
Oh, that. And they're straight for the
other villager. For the kill.
Oh, there's no way.
Ah, I love it. I love it. Yeah, the villager has been scouted. I mean, both, like all 4, I guess, have been scouted. So, yeah, this one villager, he's on the run. So, he. Ah, I love it. I think.
Oh, the villagers can take out the scout.
I think that's really, really a smart move. I mean, it's a lot easier to prevent a dock than burning it down at some point. So. Really nice. Scout getting into the action. So let's see how this turns out.
Ooh, and that villager from Griff is very low HP. And as soon as the scout from KT Fear gets into the action, this was KT Fear.
Oh. I mean, the villager
just threw everything into the dock.
The villager will at some point go down, 10 HP, that means like 10 more hits.
Oh, we need to see this with the eyes of Katie Fear, and Katie Fear sees the other villager go.
Yeah, he sees it. So, he knows what's coming there.
Also getting walls up.
He's walling off, that's hilarious. I mean, granted, you know, I wasn't expecting too much from an English mirror because I think it's one of the worst mirrors you can have, probably. But I mean, this is awesome. This is great.
That was a great start there. Of the game, and, yeah.
And the barracks. They're going for barracks at the dock. I mean, that is really, really great stuff. And by the way, the villager survived with 1 health.
Oh, but Kitty Fear is losing his villager. Ooh, and the villager is gone.
So it is 1-0 at the moment. But, I mean... And the dog is also getting up. So, I mean, Griff is going on water still. Heavily delayed, of course. And probably not in the position he wanted to be in. But he's still going on water. He didn't get deterred from that.
Yeah,
and he's also pretty close on for the age up, actually. I mean, a little bit more on food, and then he can age up. So let's see if he's going for that.
Oh, and Griff sneaked the dock in.
Yeah, exactly. So he did go for a dock at some point. It was just heavily delayed, and it was closer to KT Fear, so probably not what he wanted to go for. But I mean. It's still fine. He's still going for the dogs.
Yeah, and Kitty Fear is so far away now.
Yeah.
Oh, and we are getting a Man-at-Arms.
Getting Man-at-Arms. And
unlike the other match we watched at round 2, if the dog goes down, there's no way these sheep can keep collecting food. Because exactly, if you remember, Rue said water, and those sheep would have kept collecting food.
Exactly, and it's not the case here. I mean, right now he only has 1 ship anyway, so he doesn't have the resources to go heavily on fishing ships. But yeah, as soon as this dock is done, doesn't matter how many fishing ships he had, it's down to 0. The villager is very brave, trying to get the scout down, and it does surprisingly a lot of damage. I mean, 5 damage is just not to underestimate.
No, it's half decent.
Yeah. I mean, it's better than what any other villages on any other civ can do, so...
Getting a council hall. I really hate the positioning of the council hall. It's blocking farms, and I hate blocking farms when I'm English.
Oh. Yeah, he could have placed it like one tile more like below that, and then he wouldn't have. Yeah, that's unfortunate.
Yeah, one tile to the southeast, and the problem's fixed.
Exactly. So yeah, I mean, minor mistake here. So.
Oh, we're getting a sacrifice.
Sacrifice that. That is a dead scout. But I guess that Griff just wanted to have the council how fast, because he needs to either find a way to deal with the men-at-arms. There's three already, so that dog is going down for sure. Or he needs to apply pressure on Griff, on Katie Fear's base, and so he just wanted to have the council how fast. Although he's not... Okay, now he's going for longbows.
Okay, we got a galley out on the lake. That galley will defend. No way the men-at-arms can keep on destroying. Oh, and Griff might have turned the game around.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's the next point. I mean, like, if that's your objective, like, get a galley, you don't really care about that one space with the mill. I mean, worst case scenario, you just destroy the mill and build a new one for 50 wood. So that's more important. To defend the dock. Let's see if... So Katie Fear is not reacting to the galley at this point by going for galley. Oh, he can't. He's going for Age of Steel, so...
Oh, the dock is burning, though!
It is burning. So he needs to repair it soon. Another man-at-arm coming out.
That longbowman is going to be so annoying.
Yeah.
So, Katie Fear is playing with. Do you know on horses where they put those, gaps at the side of their eyes so that they only see forward? Katie Fear is playing with that on the dock.
Yeah.
Whereas Griff is keeping his eyes everywhere. And if Katie Fear has nothing on land, he's dead.
Yeah. Pretty much, the dock from Griff is gonna burn down. So he pulls the villager there, but that's not gonna be in time. So he needs to rebuild the dock. And
my point is, will he be able to? Because we have three longbowmen here, and the longbowmen are attacking. Griff's longbowmen are attacking Katie Fear's ones. Katie Fear scout, so that's pretty good for Katie Fear.
Oh yeah, that's for sure.
On the other hand, Griff has just re-won water, but the fishing boats have nowhere to turn it to.
Yeah, he needs to build a dock somewhere. He pulled a villager, but okay. Oh, look at the middle. So the villager is just standing there idle because the target that he wanted to repair burnt down, and so okay, now he's moving back.
So oh, Fear with the 1-2 HP villager is trying to get that gold in the middle. I swear, the amount of coincidences this game has had already, other than the chaotic start, is just out of this world.
Oh yeah.
Oh, and Fear, if Fear gets a single ship, if he had gotten a single ship, this would have been dealt with. Now Griff will be getting his water back. Okay, there we go. Finally a sprinkled ship. Hulk. Yeah, it's a sprinkled ship. Okay, that scout scouted what's going on. So we have 10 longbowmen against 9, 10, 12 longbowmen. Okay. Okay, numbers are good for Fear.
Yeah, but it's still pretty even, though. So...
It's still pretty even, yeah. But that villager is going to be able to rebuild the dock. With the sprinkled ship out, I think Fear is not in a bad position. Ooh, and Fear gets the first hit. First two kills, and I think he wins the fight.
Yeah, he has a slight advantage there, and I think if you can take away like one thing that is fun in a mirror match is that you can very easily see what was done better than, you know, than the other person did, and so you can see there's like very, very small differences that can turn the game here. It's like five longbows here, a sprinkle chip there. The villager's actually getting in on the action. I love it.
Yeah, unfortunately, they're dying, but
worth
it to Griff.
Yeah. So a slight advantage for KT here at this point in villagers. And of course, some of those numbers are from fishing ships as well. Although he lost a few, I believe.
We have two fishing ships. Oh, but Griff doesn't have enough wood to produce more more ships,
yeah.
So...
Yeah, he's got one Hulk. More...
Oh, that one Hulk is gonna be it.
And yeah, now he can go for another Hulk.
Yeah, do you know what Fear needs? Fear needs more men-at-arms.
Oh, yeah.
But he doesn't have food. Doesn't have the food. Otter got denied, and
yeah, so that's really unfortunate for him. So he lacks food. I mean, he is going like he built a couple farms already, so he's not completely relying on water. But
yeah, it's not great because all of that investment could have been put into longbowmen. Now we're in a situation where Griff really is putting up a lot of war, and we have Springles versus Springles. But this is good for Fear because the dock is burning up. Ah, but there's a villager repairing it.
There's a villager repairing, yeah.
So when here you just want to manage water, you just want to make sure that you're equal on water if you're Griff. If you're Fear, you really need it. You really need it. Yeah, I mean, you don't... Yeah, maybe really needing it is a little bit much, but... Oh, there we go. We got a fishing boat repairing a Hulk.
Yeah. Yeah, that was fun to watch. So, KD Fear pulled the fishing boat, and Griff also pulled too, and so they were just healing back and forth. And could have been like an internal battle, basically.
Oh, we have... Oh, Fear is gonna try to hit Griff.
Yeah. So, I mean...
No upgrades on either side.
About the map and how it's fought on two different ways. You have the land battle here with the longbows, and at the same time you also fight on water, so... It's a very interesting map, and it can... I mean, especially in the mirror, I guess it can go either way. What are your predictions, though? What do you think would be like the winning move right now? You mentioned Man-at-Arms.
I think someone getting Man-at-Arms would 100% be the winning move. And like both guys really have the room to do that. Especially Fear, that already has the barracks.
Oh yeah, he could pump out like at least, yeah, 4 or 5 right now. Get the upgrade.
Ooh, and we got Fear getting out also... demos.
Yeah. Oof.
Oh, the dock is fully built, though.
Yeah, the villager repaired it and went back to fishing himself. So, two demo ships coming out from King Fear. So, that's gonna... Yeah, either clear the fishing boats or make sure
Griff.
That the next Hulk...
So, Griff is a Man-at-Arms in his army, and the Man-at-Arms, I think, just... It's still a Vanguard Man-at-Arms. But the 3 ranged armor will just... It will tank a little bit along.
Oh yeah. And so Griff is getting the upgrade right now. KD Fear is not right now, so... As soon as the upgrade hits, he has the feudal Man-at-Arms. So now he has them, so... The early Man-at-Arms, they're quite good. against the longbows? I mean, okay, I guess.
If they're doing their job, no longbowman died for Griff.
Yeah, and you see like the number, I mean, it's like 26 to 8. So even though he has like he's fighting against the network of casters bonus, he's still winning the fight pretty handily. And so Griff right now, some kind of, well, somewhat winning on water, I guess, or at least not losing. And on land, he has the superior mass. So
we did just lose his ship some water. So now Fear is winning there.
Yeah,
but Fear is losing on land. What a back and forth game. Ooh, two villages on farms. Ooh. One of them dies. The other one barely.
But the palisade wall. The palisade wall is really nice. I mean, just imagine the longbows walking in there in the wood line, and there's like 26 villagers. They would have all been dead, basically.
Make it 27. There's another one just spawned.
Right.
And now I think Fear will just be doing his thing on water and getting a bunch of fishing ships out. I think 6 is ideal, right? Two per pond. Deep fish.
Yeah, that sounds about right, yeah. I guess you could maybe go for 3 in the early game if you want to have it faster, but it's, I mean, at some point they will just be idle, so yeah, 2 probably would be ideal. We noticed that earlier in the Roos game as well. I mean, he had like 3 fishing ships or something per fish, and it just ran out all the time, and they went back and forth, and it was not really worth it, I guess.
Getting another range, so Fear wants to double down on the longbowman. Which I think you can, if you get the upgrade, because of the man at arms.
If you get the upgrade, for sure, yeah.
Okay, another kill. Okay, no dock for Griff, but he gets a dock in an even weirder spot. And in the meantime, we have the army just moving beneath the TC, but they're attacking downhill. Man at arms just surviving so well.
Yeah, I mean, you can see, like, Griff is outnumbering with longbows 2-1 at this point, so you can easily trade here and idle the villagers, the farms here, so. Yeah, I wonder if Griff should just give up water completely at this point. I don't know if you can come back to it at this point.
Yeah, he's just losing water.
I mean, if he somehow cleans up the barracks and the dock, then yeah, then it's a different situation. But right now, I mean, he's just building a dock to be destroyed and over again.
And Griff is even losing his army.
Yeah, that was interesting. I mean, the longbows from KD Fear came in, trickling in, and so at some point it just switched. Interesting.
Oh, we're gonna get a demo against the galley? That was not ideal.
Nope.
And we're gonna get a second dock just to make sure that we have the vision. In the meantime, Griff is really throwing this one. He needed to keep that mass together. He tried to split them up. I mean, he got kills. I'll give him that. But he's also, like, he lost his fish. Not ideal. His 1 TC. And now he has a mass together. But so does Fear. And Fear has to get his mass together. Otherwise, he might lose that fight.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty even right now, or KDF even a little bit ahead. So as soon as he has the outpost, you know, network of castles bonus, Griff cannot fight there. And neither player has gotten any upgrades at this point. So neither damage nor armor. Which I think, well, I guess if both don't get it, it's fine, but I love to see this though. Oh, no. Now Griff is getting the upgrade as we speak, so he's listening, that's great. And going for King's Palace.
Going for the King's Palace as well, yeah. And
which I think is a great choice.
I think so too, yeah. You lost water, this is your way back. This is a TC.
Exactly, yeah. Yeah, I mean, it's I don't know if you can break it down in such a simple way, but I mean, if you want to get ahead in eco, there's trade, water, or another TC. And so he lost water, he could trade, but I mean, why would he? And so he needs to go for another TC. And it's an okay spot, like spot as well, with the stone, gold right next to it, a little bit of wood as well, so should help him out big time.
And there we go, Griff. Oh, he's fighting just before the upgrade comes through.
Yeah, he was in the middle of the fight while he was having the getting the upgrades and also the age up, so
Oh, what are those villagers doing? Oh, that is a
I don't know,
misclick.
but they're luckily coming to their senses. So the fight's still pretty even, men at arm in the front as well, so upgrade is coming in as well. So now he's getting the veteran longbows. As soon as he hits that, he is in a very good position. So at least army-wise, King's Palace is just pumping out villagers as well, so
Also getting the man-at-arms upgrade.
yeah, very important. You really want that. I mean, the difference between early men-at-arms from feudal age and castle men-at-arms is huge. So
Yeah,
he
night
really
and
needs
day.
that.
I think it's not 10 HP, it's like 40 HP.
Yeah, it's quite a lot of HP, and then it's more armor as well, and more damage in case you actually reach the longbows, and especially if the opponent is still with fuel longbows, like you can shred through them as easily. At the same time, Katie Fear is going up with the King's Palace as well, also with 15 villagers, so both going up with 15 pretty fast, dropping a lot of stables as well. Good choice.
Are going with
So,
stable, so you might want to go with knights.
oh yeah.
And like he's got a ton of food, we might as well spend it. Griff goes with I'm trying to get crossbowmen without scouting anything. So now Fear might throw a curveball and go with horsemen. And regular horsemen they deal with really well.
That's true. That's true.
I have no idea
Also,
if anybody is scouting all of this that's happening, given that it's last-minute ordeals. We are getting all of the upgrades. We're getting armor clad. We're getting iron under mash for Griff, so he's gonna be very well upgraded. Fear is behind in upgrades. If you look at the per minutes, Fear has a lot more door. I doesn't even have a lot more resources.
no, it doesn't. Well, and to answer your earlier question, none of them is scouting anything. I don't think they even have a scout at this point, so they're basically
No, they
playing
don't.
completely blind. And I mean, I guess you kind of can guess what the opponent is doing if you're in a mirror, and especially a English mirror. I think it's very predictable. Yeah, crossbow is not a bad decision at all, because yeah, he probably expects knights coming out,
I think he
and
expects
indeed,
men-at-arms coming out.
well yeah, but or men at arms, but either way, the crossbows are great,
The
and the
crossbowmen
thing
work,
is,
yeah. Do your opponent a
and
crossbowman.
there are knights coming out from KD Fear as well actually, so the crossbows will be a good choice.
Look at that single
So
longbowman on the south side of the map going into harass.
that is great stuff.
Griff getting a mangy and. Does
Yep.
Griff have a dock? Oh, Griff managed to get a dock, dock in.
Oh, right in the corner there. Oh my. What? 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 Oh man. And he's
But he's
housed.
housed! Oh no! He's
By the way,
housed!
this is like the second or third time it happened this game. So now he's been dropping like three houses at once to not run into this issue for a while now, but
Part
that
of his
is
army is gonna die. I think problem is solved. Okay.
exactly. Just throw away your army and then you're not housed anymore. That's like a five head.
Yeah, there we go, and that mangonel is gonna be so good. We got a really good army from Griff. I
Yeah.
think, in particular, the men-at-arms are excellent.
Oh yeah, I really like the man at arms in this situation. I mean, the knights are also good on the other side, but yeah, very different army compositions. A lot of longbows and men at arms on the one side by Kriv, and then a lot of longbows and a couple of knights by Katie Fear. But way too few knights actually. I mean, three knights is not enough, and he has to run from the mango. If that hits, oh yeah, that's brutal. So
game hits, game's over.
Yeah, I mean, if he loses, like, yeah, half his longbows, it's over. He will probably not have enough time to recover from it. Despite still winning water and going pretty heavily actually on water. I mean, how many fishing ships does he have right now? It's like 10, 11, 14 fishing boats. Okay.
That's way too many, I think. Oh, we get a tower that was getting built by Griff that will be denied.
Yeah, hey,
that villager is dead. We have a ram!
We have a ram going in on the king's palace. No, not even the king's palace, never mind. Going on a blacksmith. That's interesting. And a counter Mangonel.
Oh, let's go! Mangonel versus Mangonel! And two amazing hits!
Great shot, great shot. And another one hitting. Oh. Okay, the Mangonel did get destroyed by the man at arms, but it still managed to kill, like, what's that? At least like 6-7 longbows. So. Okay, immediate keep drop here. He just depleted the stone and just dropping a keep here. I mean, it is very far behind. And it's not going up. Oh, that's unfortunate. So yeah, Katie Fear is running out of army at this point. I mean, he doesn't have a lot right now.
Running out of everything, really, and the knights don't do much with the crosswoman in there.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, it was just too little. Another keep drop attempt.
Yeah, Fear just wants to drop a keep. And the men-at-arms are so annoying.
Of course he wants to drop a keep. Yeah, I mean, he has no way to deal with the men-at-arms. He would need to have at least, like, I don't know, 20 crossbowmen to deal with that. And he's at, what right now, 5? So...
Yeah, just... He's got nothing. Oh. I think that if he had the blacksmith upgrades way earlier, maybe he could have dealt with this, but yeah, now it's too late.
Yeah,
he's sacrificing everybody.
It is a maybe, and I mean, yeah, he gets the keep up most likely if he doesn't tap out, but I mean, for what cost? And if you look at the south of the base, like, the men at arms just completely destroyed the farms over there. I mean, all the villagers there got killed. Griff killed 62 villagers. I mean, that is a, like, oh. Great
62
stuff. I mean,
villagers. 62 to 11.
Yeah.
And 50 to the count, that's 101. That's not bad.
No, not at all. So you can really feel the difference here in villagers. And I mean, Katie Fear is actually lucky that he can get gold from this one gold vein. Just some knights passed it just a couple seconds ago. So he is really, really behind right now.
Oh my god, those men at arms just do not die.
They do not die. They don't want to die.
Even death is afraid of them.
Well, I mean, like, 7 armor, right? I mean, it's like
7 armor, and they don't have the last blacksmith upgrades.
I mean, even the keep is only doing like 6 damage per shot, and Katie Fear can't hold on anymore. GG.
Yeah, GG. That's map 1 going to Griff. Yeah.
I have to say, this was a lot better than I expected from an English mirror. I have to admit.
And this is action from the get-go. Instead of turtle from the get-go, which is what you get on land most of the time.
Yeah, they incorporated everything. I mean, you had land fights, you had water fights, back and forth, you know, all kinds of ships, all kinds of units, different unit composition, raiding coming in even. Like, this game had everything.